Welcome. In this video, we'll see the features present in PIC16F877 microcontroller. So this PIC16F877 microcontroller is having a high performance 8-bit RISC CPU. So 8-bit RISC CPU means it can process or it can operate on 8-bit data simultaneously, and it is having RISC CPU. RISC stands for Reduced Instruction Set Computer. Then it is having only 35 assembly language instructions. So using these 35 instructions, we have to write assembly language programs for PIC16F877 microcontroller. Then all these instructions are of one clock cycle. It means that all the instructions can be executed in a single clock cycle. Only some of the instructions are there, like branching instructions, which require two clock cycles. Then the operating speed for this PIC microcontroller is from DC to 20 megahertz. So DC means we can operate or we can give the signal to the clock input pin using a switch. So that switch can be either connected to VCC or it can be connected to the ground. So when we press the switch, a clock will be given and the instruction will be executed. So that is nothing but DC. And 20 megahertz is the maximum clock frequency that can be given as an input to the PIC16F877 microcontroller. Then it is having 8K by 14 words of flash program memory. So 8 kilobytes is the capacity of that flash memory. So we are having 8K locations in the memory, whereas 14 means on a single memory location we can store 14 bits. Next is 368 by 8 bytes of data RAM. So there are 368 RAM locations, and on each location we can store 8 bit of data. So this RAM memory is used for temporary storage, whereas the flash program memory is used for storing the program or the code. So the next memory is 256 by 8 bytes of E2PROM data memory. So this E2PROM data memory is used for storing some data, user data like passwords, or you can store the constant values which are not going to change. So the capacity of this E2PROM data memory is of 256 bytes, and on a single location we can store 8 bits of data. Then the pinout of this 16F877 is compatible with other family of controllers which are mentioned over here, that is 16C, 73B, then 74B, 76 and 77. Then it can have 14 different interrupt sources. Interrupt signal is used to interrupt the CPU and provide service to the external device or to some other peripheral. So there are such 14 different interrupt sources. Then we have 8 level deep hardware stack. So stack is used for storing the temporary data. So generally in case of PIC16F877, this stack is not accessible to user. So this stack is used by CPU for storing the value present in program counter. So whenever there is a call to a subroutine, automatically the value present in program counter will be stored onto the stack. And there are such 8 stack locations. So we can call 8 nested subroutines. So these subroutines can store the address of program counter onto the stack and the return address from the subroutine onto the stack. Then next is there are 3 addressing modes, that is direct addressing mode, indirect addressing mode and immediate addressing mode for the instructions. So addressing mode is the way by which we can access the operands for the instruction. We have a power on reset facility. So this power on reset facility is used to reset the CPU. So whenever we turn on the power supply, the CPU is resetted and then it will start working. Then next is power up timer. So this power up timer is used to monitor the timing till which the power supply has not reached to the rated value. So this power up timer provides a delay. So during that delay, the controller remains in reset state. So once the delay is completed, the power up timer will overflow and it will indicate that the power supply is reached to the rated value and CPU can start its operation. Next timer is oscillator startup timer. So this oscillator startup timer again provides a delay till the clock signal of the CPU reaches to the rated value. So whenever we have connected any crystal to a controller to generate the clock signal, it does not directly generate the rated frequency. So it takes some time to reach to that rated frequency. So that time delay which is required for that crystal to reach to the rated frequency is provided, that time delay is provided by this oscillator startup timer. So whenever this delay is not completed, at that time the CPU will remain in reset state. And once this oscillator startup timer delay has completed, it will come out of the reset and the CPU will start working. The next feature is it is having a watchdog timer with its own on-chip RC oscillator for reliable operation. So this watchdog timer is used to monitor the working of CPU. Suppose if CPU is not working properly or if it has gone to some infinite loop, then the watchdog timer will overflow and it will reset the CPU, and CPU will start executing the program from the beginning. And on the other hand, if suppose CPU is working properly, then it will reset the watchdog timer at particular instance and it will avoid the overflow of watchdog timer, because if watchdog timer overflows, it will reset the CPU. So this watchdog timer is basically used to monitor the working of CPU. And this watchdog timer is having its own RC oscillator for reliable operation. So the clock signal which is used for giving clock to the watchdog timer is taken from a RC oscillator instead of the CPU oscillator. Then next is the programmable code memory protection. So we have an option in PIC16F877 to protect the code memory so that nobody else can read the code which is present in the program memory, and we do not have write permission or as well as read permission for that code memory which is protected. Next feature is it is having power saving sleep mode. So whenever the CPU is not going to do any work, at that time we can put that CPU in sleep mode. So this helps to reduce the power consumption. Next feature is selectable oscillator options. So using this oscillator options, we can have different type of clock signals, or rather different type of clock inputs to the controller. So we can have a high speed crystal oscillator, we can have a low speed crystal oscillator or low power crystal oscillator, or we can give a RC oscillator, and so on. So different options are available as a, for the clock signal of PIC16F877. The next is low power high speed CMOS flash E-square PROM technology. So the technology that is used for building the memories which are present in PIC16F877 is a high speed CMOS flash technology which consumes a very low amount of power. Then next feature is in circuit serial programming via two pins. So using these two pins, we can program the PIC controller serially by keeping that IC in the system itself. We don't have to remove the IC from the system for programming. The serial programming capability can be done with the help of a single 5 volt supply. Then it also has another feature called as in-circuit debugging via two pins. So we can debug the program which is present in the controller using two debug pins, which can be again done in the system itself. So we can execute a single instruction in the actual hardware and we can check the output. So just like we do in the software debugging, so similarly hardware debugging facility is also available for PIC16F877. Then next feature is processor read write access to program memory. So we can have a particular read or write access to the program memory. So some part of the program memory can be protected so that there is no read or write access to that program memory. Then it has a wide operating voltage range from 2 volt to 5.5 volts. So we can give any supply in between this voltage range. Then it is having a high sinking and sourcing current capacity that is of 25 milliamperes. So it can sink 25 milliamperes of current or it can source 25 milliamperes of current. So for most of the applications, we can directly connect the pins to the external peripherals so that no extra driver is required. Then commercial and industrial temperature ranges are available for this controller. Then the low power consumption is also there. That is, it takes less than 2 milliampere current for at 5 volt and 4 megahertz frequency. Then it takes 20 microampere current whenever we are operating the controller at 3 volts and 32 kilohertz. So as we reduce the voltage and frequency, the power consumption also decreases. So whenever we have a battery operated system, in that case we can have a low voltage as well as low frequency system, so that the power consumption will be less and the battery backup will be more. Another feature is that it can have only less than 1 microampere of current whenever it is in standby mode or whenever it is in sleep mode. So this is about the features present in PIC16F877. In the next video, we'll see the different architectures which are used for building the controller and the internal architecture of PIC16F877. Thank you.